For these Filipino-American activists, the Mamasapano clash points to one thing, that President Aquino is unfit for office.
The pork barrel issue that's still unresolved right now is still an ongoing thing, and he swept that under the rug. And now he's, you know, showing us that he can't even keep his own men, the Philippine National Police, his own men protected, and he wasn't even there at their burial. So I think at this point, the people really feel his neglect.
They also say how the operation was a failure despite U.S. involvement.
The Philippine government is hiding that the U.S. had any involvement, but because, again, it goes back to the violation of our constitution that no foreign activity should be happening on our land.
They also cite Aquino's failing leadership when the families of the fallen soldiers and survivors say they felt insulted and disrespected when they were visited by the president.
He's stalling the investigations of Mamasapano by going to these fallen SAS family members. But when they ask him the hard questions, he can't even answer them. And I think that really shows who he serves, and he serves himself.
The activists are also saying that Filipino-Americans should be made aware of the Mamasapano clash because they are indirectly aiding these events.
We have to remind ourselves, it's our tax dollars that we really work hard for that get sent to the military in the Philippines to make these operations successful.
People! Power! People! Power!
Following these community forums, these Filipino-American activists are planning a National Day of Action this Tuesday to call on the resignation of President Aquino and to commemorate the People Power Revolution. Ramel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.